Students, today we will discuss comparison of van der Waals PV curves with experimental PV curves. I am Dr. S.B. Kolle, Department of Physics, Shivaji Arts, Commerce and Science College, Kannan, District Aurangabad. So, you know van der Waals equation of state, P plus A upon V square into V minus V is equal to RT. Equation first, from this, P can be calculated as P is equal to RT upon V minus B minus A upon V square. Now curves between pressure and volume at various temperatures are drawn using equation first, and these are shown in figure A. Now PV curves obtained by van der Waals equation are compared with CO2 isotherms obtained by Andrews instrument. So see here, this figure A shows PV curves using van der Waals equation. These are theoretical curves. And figure C shows these PV curves are isotherms of CO2 by Andrews instrument. These are practical curves. And middle figure B shows Andrews instrument setup. So first of all, we will discuss this setup. Here A, B, two glass tubes. And thick capillary tubes on the top. Here mercury pellet is there. Here air, and here CO2 gas is there. And this S and S dash screws apply pressure to this system. And here is water. It is a S-shaped copper vessel. And you see here this air obeys Boyle's law. And it's from this length of this capillary here, its volume can be calculated, and from this its pressure can be calculated, and these air and CO2 are at same pressure. So after calculation of this pressure of air, we can calculate pressure of this CO2 gas, and from this length of this tube it is calibrated, so we can find volume of this CO2 gas. In this way, pressure and volume for this CO2 gas are calculated, and using this pressure and volume values, we can draw PV curves here. These are pressure and volume curves are there. So these are PV curves by this Andrews instrument for CO2 gas. Now we will compare this PV curves by van der Waals equation and PV curves by Andrews instrument for CO2 gas. And then we will see what they show. So see here at 13.1 degree Celsius, this curve is like this. So A to B, it is gaseous state, and A to B can be explained as super cooling of vapors, and E to D, ED along ED, it is superheating of liquid. We can see here A to B pressure increasing, volume is decreasing. Here also pressure increasing and volume also it is decreasing. So, but along BCD, we see pressure decreasing and volume also decreasing. It is not acceptable. So again, see here, the curve is same for 21.5 degrees Celsius. But here 31.1 degrees Celsius, the curve is quite different. See here, there is only one point is there. This portion is minimized here. It is converted to only one point. Now we will see from this figure C, it to be gaseous state. At B, liquid, this gas starts liquefying. So see here, from B to C, the gas is converting to liquid. Here this portion shows liquid and vapor mixture. At C, the vapor is completely liquefied, and along CD it is liquid region. So it is 31.1 degrees Celsius, and these are at different temperatures. These curves are at different temperatures. Temperature is increasing in this way. As temperature increases, this horizontal portion decreases. See here, this portion is converted to only one point, and this point is called critical point. At this point, temperature is called critical temperature, and pressure of this point is critical pressure PC, critical temperature TC. sea, and beyond this critical temperature, the gas cannot be liquefied, though we increase the pressure. So this curves obeys Boyle's law. These are ideal gas. This curve symbols ideal gas curves. Means in practical the curves are ideal gas curves, and in this here also in this figure, beyond this critical temperature the curves are similar to that of practical curves. So this is the comparison between this practical and theoretical PV curves by inducement and by van der Waals equation. So the reference I used for preparation of this PowerPoint presentation. Thank you.